Today's the day. I'm so excited, I don't even know what to say. But today, for the first time, I'm gonna use a wood lathe. So let's figure this out. Okay, well, before we get started, there's some things I need to discuss with you. And that has to do with the Delta. Came in, it had a problem. Every manufacturer has problems. Every company has a problem. Every person has problems. That's not the issue. The issue is how you handle them. And in my opinion, Delta did not handle this very well. I can't fix Delta, okay? It was touch and go there for a while as to whether or not I would return this machine. It's a simple thing. It's a simple fix. And in the end, it'll be fixed. Let me show you what the problem is. Okay, here's the tool post rest bracket. See this hole? See the middle of it? The middle of the bracket? That hole is supposed to be over here. And what the problem that causes is when you go to put the tool post in, and of course I just dropped the part that I needed. I don't know if you can see down in there, but when you spin this in, it does not come through enough to engage the post itself. The problem? This hole is in the wrong spot. So all they had to do was either replace this piece, which they don't want to do. But what they are doing is they're going to resupply me and a lot of other customers with a longer version of this lockdown. In the meantime, here's my solution. I just knocked it on the floor. That's not where I normally keep it. Went to my local hardware store, and I just got another bolt. Now, I talked to Delta. Delta says they're not going to void the warranty. So, let's get to turning some wood. Well, you know I'm out here in the middle of nowhere. And this particular middle of nowhere, there's not a lot of trees. And the trees we do have, not really good for turning wood. They're soft. They're real soft. Cottonwood is just, it's soft. So what I have an old fence post, and 4x4, don't know what it's made out of, does not appear to, no, it's not pressure treated, 21 inches long. So the first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cut it into three pieces, and then I'm gonna knock the corners of it off. Let's start with something that's at least a little bit rounder, at least for my first attempt, okay? So let me get this cut into three pieces, get the corners knocked off, and we'll go from there. Starting off real good here. It's kind of hard to cut 45s on this particular table saw.
I'm gonna have to figure it out. So once I get that figured out, we'll be back and we'll round these 4x4s off. Okay, well, I've decided not to round them off. It was taking me too much time. I don't know what I'm doing. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna bolt the faceplate up to this using some wood screws on a flatter surface and chuck it up and start spinning. I gotta tell you, I'm nervous. I probably haven't made this many mistakes in my shop in 10 minutes in my life. I was awake at 1:30 this morning thinking, you think my wife would mind if I went out in the shop and started working on it? And then it dawned on me, it's about 20 degrees in my shop, so anyway, I'm nervous. But here we go. Now, one thing. I'm not gonna wear the face shield for the first time. No, I take that back. I'm gonna put the face shield on. I don't know if I've got this chucked up right. I don't know anything. So, I'm gonna wear the face shield. You might not be able to hear me. I may have to do voiceover or whatever later, but this is it. This is my first time. Well, have you ever had one of those days? This is my first turning. And if it was my second turning or third turning, I'd just delete all the video and just start over. But it's my first. When I went to put the face shield on, I put on an external mic. I've used it a bunch of other times. But this is a brand new camera. Before, I was just using my phone. I obviously didn't know how to use this camera. So, as soon as I plugged it in, from that point on, no audio. I have a second camera, and about three quarters of the way through the project, it just quit working too. So, I am going to try to put together as much of this video as I can, and make a video out of it. Like I said, this is my first, so it's got to be documented. One more thing. Because it's my first, it has to be documented. But I've already put the shellac on it and finished it. So what I'll do is I'm going to turn another one tomorrow. I'm going to take what I learned today, turn another one. And when we get to the finish part, I'll bring the cameras back out and we'll go over the finish part. And I'll make a fourth video, and the fourth video will be, you know, my first experience at finishing. Okay? Well, let's see if we can salvage this video.
I don't know what I'm doing. Yeah, I don't know if I'm supposed to lock this in or not, but I'm going to go ahead and lock it in. I set the speed, according to the wall, they send you a little chart, and I set the speed according to the chart, it's close between, based on the diameter, and I don't think it's hardwood, it's supposed to be 500 to 750 for rough gouging. So, that's where I set it. The only thing that when I was going through the decision process, trying to decide which one to buy, one of the things was the limiting factor on this guy was it did not have a speed indicator. I don't know how tight that's supposed to be. That's in. I'm going to stand to one side, spin it. I think it's going the wrong way. That's interesting. I have to put it in reverse to make it spin this way. And I thought that was the normal way. Well, I don't know. So what I want to do first, get this guy set. So we'll set it to its outer point. Raise this up to just below the center. Lock this down. Not kidding, I think that's too close. Based on my zero experience. So that's locked in. That appears to be parallel. So let me get my other wrench. This is actually a wrench from a garbage disposal install kit. It works. That's locked in. Got my John Deere magnet right there. So the first thing I'm going to use is the square for rough gouging. And I'm even going to put gloves on. I mean, I'm going all out here. I set this down as a tool holder, but I'm afraid I'll miss and grab it on the concrete. So, today's goal. Today's goal is to make a cylinder. And if I can make a cylinder, well, we'll figure out what we're going to do past that. Right? I think this is too high. I think that's too high. No, that is too high. Because what I didn't take into account was the thickness of the tool itself. So, you know? You just gotta do it.
Thank you.
Okay. I'll fix that later. Okay, one thing. When I first set this up, I thought it was gonna be too short. Completely wrong. The height on this is actually pretty good. So I was wrong there. I don't have it all the way down to a cylinder, but I just wanted to talk to you about a few things. One, I'm finding out that it's soft. I don't know what that means, but it's coming out in chunks. But it's okay. This is a practice. What I'm also finding out is that it's not easy to keep a nice flat surface. I mean, this thing it looks like ocean waves. With that said, anyway, I just wanted to smack in the face in the camera there, and then I just wanted to give you those impressions before I forgot about them. And I'm trying to get a nice, smooth finish on it. People that do this that are really good at it, my God, they make it look so easy. And you know, I'm not overly concerned, but I'll get there. But boy, you just don't walk up and just, hey, look what I can do. I've also put this mark here. Those are my screw heads. So I don't want to go any deeper than that. So I'll just leave this here and probably come up here with a parting tool at the end. And, like, I know what I'm talking about. I'll cut it off there somehow. Another point. I intentionally did not watch YouTube videos on how to use carbide. The reason I didn't is I get confused. I need to visually see it, and I need to visually, and I need to feel it. I need to have the experiences. Otherwise, they're just words. and I'm not going to retain them. So once I get through this, I'll go back, I'll watch some of the videos, and I'll have a better understanding of what they're saying. Another thing I'm finding is this has got a flat surface on the bottom here, and I keep tilting it like this and kind of fighting it. What I have to do is relax and just let the tool and the tool rest do their job. And I'm coming up to a knot here, so I'll slow down a little bit. Okay, we're almost down to the cylinder. I want to take this down here a little bit. I don't want to go past my mark there, but I want to take this area here down a little bit. And you can see it. I don't know why I didn't see it before, but you can see it now. Again, letting that tool. And again, this is not expert advice. This is just my experience. Okay, so I got a tube. Now what I want to do, that's with the square one. I'll put that down here. It's going to freak me out, but I'll get used to it. And this here is the round one. And it's supposed to smooth it. I want to practice with it. Set up wrong or what, but I keep having to step over it. I'll get used to it. Yeah, this is definitely more art than sand. What I'm doing is I'm actually looking for spots that this is smoothing out, and I try to do it with this. Okay, now, it's a tube. It's a cylinder. I think I can change the speed now. So a couple things I want to check is based on diameter and what you're doing according to my chart here. And so I need to figure out what diameter is. Why does it matter? Of course my apron's on inside out, so my tools are all buried in there. So we're looking at about 3 inches close enough. And so according to the chart here, we can take up to about 1,500 RPMs. 1,500 RPMs is the minimum. So, you open this guy up, which is off, 1,500 is in the mid-range of the two pulleys, of the center pulley. So, unplug it, open up the bottom door, release the belt tensioner, roll it over to the middle one, down inside here, roll this on the middle one. Again, this is not a how to use a Delta lathe video, so close the door, apply the tension, close this door. This goes 1 to 9, so we'll set it at 4, and I'm going to move my tool rest in a little bit. And I'm going to spin it to make sure it's safe, and I'm going to turn it on again. And it doesn't work if you don't plug it in. Plug this in. Hit the switch, and we are good to go. So, what next? I don't know. So, I think what I want to do is get the tailstock out of here, and then I'm going to run just practice on this end piece here, and go from there. Put that back there. Undo this, and this is another big. I've never done this before, so I don't know how to do it, but we'll figure it out. I think I'm going to go back to the square one and just run it across. Again, fighting the tool stock. I think I'm a little high, so I'm going to lower it down a bit. Blocking everything here. I can readjust. There, do better. Actually, I think that's too low. Again, all my years of experience. Over to the round one. See if I can get a little more. surface area. One video I did watch, it talked about the speed at the outside, because it's longer, it's faster than the speed on the inside. You can really feel that difference. Gone this far. I think what I'm going to make this today is going to be a pencil holder. So, what I need to do, even if it's a vase, if it turns out to be a vase, it turns out to be a vase. What I want to do is, I now need to drill, set up the chuck, and run the Forstner bit into here, and the Forstner bit into here, and cut a cavity out of the middle, and then start cleaning that out. Again, never done it before, so we get to figure it out. So, I do about an inch or so at a time, back it out, clean it out. So it's taking time. I'll bring you back when I move on to profiling. Okay, well, I got the Forstner bit done. And one thing I forgot to do when I first started doing it is I forgot to reduce the speed. It's important that, depending on your bit size, you reduce the speed of your work, otherwise you're going to burn it. So, anyway, when I figured that out, it actually started to cut instead of smoke. So now I'm going to start working on the profile. I'm going to open this here up a little bit, smooth this over here, taper this in, and then just, I think it's called a potato, I don't know. Just give it a little different profile, type 3-4 anyway. So, that is the plan. So, I don't know.
Well, my first turning's done. It's not perfect. It's not even close. But it was my first, and seeing that we started off with basically a fence post, I'd say we made some progress today.